Greetings. This is Healy from the Australian Strategic Operations Regiment. On behalf of the community, we're creating a series of video resources to enhance their training and development. In this video, we'll be taking a look at weapons and marksmanship basics. In ASOR, we use a variety of weapons across various campaigns and scenarios. To save time, I'll briefly touch on weapons and scopes used when we play as a modern-day Special Operations Force. ASOR runs a variety of weapon platforms, but the most common tend to cartridge 5.56 by 45 caliber ammunition. 5.56 is a light, versatile cartridge, which performs well in both close-quarter combat and mid-range engagements. The ability to share ammunition within our squads tends to encourage us to run a weapon platform of the same cartridge. Most weapons are highly modular, allowing you to change barrel attachments such as suppressors and flash hiders, as well as various rail attachments such as scopes, grenade launchers, grips, lasers, and flashlights. Your effectiveness with a weapon often depends on your ability to aim with a sight or scope. It goes without saying that before using your weapon, you should create the best possible environment to fire from. This includes utilizing your bipod, bracing yourself on objects, and crouching or going prone wherever possible. Furthermore, understanding how to read certain scopes will increase your combat effectiveness. In this example, we'll take a brief look at the Elkhan Spectre. Under the main crosshair of the Elkhan, there are a series of other crosshairs with a number designation. The numbers signify the range of a target in meters. The horizontal line of the crosshair is designed to be matched against the shoulder width of an enemy combatant to account for bullet drop. For example, this target's shoulder width matches the third crosshair. This means he is 300 meters away and I can engage him with the same crosshair. The next contact is 400 meters away and I can engage him with the same method. Most scopes will have a crosshair or mil dot arrangement which works in the same fashion, allowing you to estimate the range of an enemy and engage appropriately. You can also adjust your weapon's sights to account for bullet drop when engaging targets at greater range. This is called zeroing or sighting in, and you can do this using the page up and page down keys. If, for example, you know an enemy is at 300 meters, you can adjust your zeroing to 300 on your scope. This would cause your primary crosshair to be zeroed at 300 meters. Lastly, it's important to know that regardless of your scope or zeroing, most 5.56 caliber weapons begin to lose effectiveness at ranges past 400 meters. We'll discuss different caliber rifles and greater distance shooting in another video. For now, that concludes our video on marksmanship basics, and we hope you learnt something from this video. We'll see you on the field.